Last year, I put together a video with 5 indie racing games you should play, and you guys seems to have enjoyed it, so I'm back with another one with 5 more. Like with the last video, the games I suggest on this one are games I actually enjoy playing, so let's dive right in. The graphics on this one might turn a lot of people off, but I don't really think that's where the developer focused on. And the reason why I'm saying this with confidence is that once you start playing it, you realize exactly where most of the development time went into on this one. ZEEPKIST caters to people who enjoy games like Trackmania. It's a physics-based racing game where you need to figure out how to keep the momentum going and how to keep steering adjustments to a minimum if you want to go for the fastest times. The Trackmania inspiration is so evident that you'll go through sections that shift into first-person perspective and then back into third-person. Not only that, but this game can be brutally difficult, just like Trackmania. It takes a lot of consistency to master this game, as one small slip up is enough to cost you an entire run. The game's kinda bare bones for now because it's in early access, and you'll notice that most of the sounds are missing, but this is not a bug. They haven't been added to the game yet, but it's coming. The developer have been constantly updating the game with fixes and new features. Online multiplayer is in the roadmap and it's expected to be added to the game pretty soon. This is the type of game I play in short bursts to keep the frustration to a minimum, as I'll advance a couple of stages and then get stuck on another one for a really long time. If you like challenging games, this one might be for you. ZEEPKIST is available on PC in early access through Steam, and for now it doesn't have a release date. From the creator of Absolute Drift, Art of Rally keeps the same gameplay style and feel, but on rally stages instead. I did a review of this game last year in case you want to get a more in-depth look at what it has to offer. I'll leave a link to it in the description down below, but you're not here for in-depth looks, so here's a short summary. Art of Rally is yet another game that can deceive you on the surface if all you're looking at are graphics. The real depth is in the core mechanics of the game. The physics can be very arcadey if you turn up all of the assists, but if you turn them all off and set damage to simulation, it feels like a completely different game. It almost feels like a sim racer that's very difficult to master. And on top of that, the AI is brutally difficult at higher difficulties, so you need to stay consistent throughout the entire stage, as one small slip up is enough to lose you first place. The single player content is fairly beefy. There are a ton of events to go through spanning across all of the different eras, you unlock cars and liveries constantly, and there are plenty of different modes to seek your teeth into, including online scheduled events where you compete for the fastest times. And if you enjoy a bit more freedom, you can customize your own events as well. There are enough cars and track locations to keep you busy for a long time, and if you like top-down racers, rally, and the ability to tweak the amount of challenge to your liking, you might want to give Art of Rally a try. Art of Rally is available on PC, Xbox, PlayStation, and Switch. The game is also available to Xbox Game Pass subscribers on PC and Xbox. Distance is kind of a weird game, and I say weird because it's the only racing game I can think of with an eerie atmosphere, and the soundtrack has a lot to do with it. It goes from fairly upbeat tracks to tracks that seem taken straight out of an horror game. Distance has a little bit of that Infinite Runner vibe, despite not being one. You're basically put on a long stretch of a track, and your job is to make it to the end, making use of all of the mechanics available to avoid either crashing and exploding, falling off the track, or being sliced in the middle by lasers, to name just a few of the stuff you have to pay attention to. The game does a very good job at easing you into the mechanics one by one. You start out dodging obstacles by turning left and right in a turbo that helps you clear gaps and go faster. Just a few stages in and you'll be jumping and even flying. What's so appealing to me about this game is that the gameplay loop is addicting. Once you get a feel for everything you're able to do in the game and sort of built it into your muscle memory, it becomes the type of game where you can zone out and go through stage after stage. There's a ton of single player content with 2 free expansions you unlock by progressing through the main campaign. There's online multiplayer and also an awesome level editor for you to create your own tracks. And if you're like me and don't have the patience to create your own stuff, you can download all the levels that other people shared with the community. Distance is available on PC through Steam, and I definitely recommend you check it out. Now, I'm not gonna lie, 80s Overdrive caught my attention by the colorful cover art while I was browsing through Steam earlier this year, and in just a few minutes it was clear to me that it's the type of game specifically made for people who grew up in the 90s. And if you're one of them and you spent a good part of your childhood playing games like Top Gear and OutRun, you'll feel right at home with this one. You have an overhead map where you gradually unlock events as you win races and earn money, and with this money you buy new cars and upgrades. Every so often you get an offer to complete a specific task within a race, like finishing ahead of a certain racer or even having to throw the race to a rival. Doing this gets you extra money, which is kind of important in this game. And the reason why money is important is that each race costs you money to enter, whether you win or lose. At some point during my many playthroughs of this game, I ran out of money and I was introduced to a cute minigame where you have to clean someone else's car for 50 bucks. This always makes me chuckle. In race, you have to make it to the end of the stage while avoiding the fairly erratic traffic that has the tendency to swerve into your lane at the very last minute. And on top of that, you have a fuel and damage meter to worry about. I'd say the damage meter is actually more important than the fuel meter because you're constantly chased by police in this game, and if you fail to avoid their brake checks, you'll end up with massive amounts of damage dealt to your car. Despite all of that, it's a breeze to play through this game, and it's a fairly enjoyable experience overall. Except for that last race. Not sure if they updated that, but the last time I played through this game, which wasn't that long ago, that last race almost made me rip my hair apart. The graphics look gorgeous, with colors that pop and backgrounds that look really good. The soundtrack is awesome too, and it fits this game really well. If you like classic racers, you can't go wrong with this game. 80s Overdrive is available on PC and Nintendo Switch, and weirdly enough, Nintendo 3DS. Taking the top spot on this list is Circuit Superstars. This game spent quite a bit of time in early access and I was able to see it evolving over time, but it's now complete and the final version was released this past week. Now, let me go through the reasons why it's number one on this list. The reason why I love indie racing games is that they're simple. Very simple, actually. There are no tricks, there's no padding, and overall I'd say there's not as much emphasis in post-launch DLC as most modern big AAA racing games have. Circuit Superstars excels at the simplicity, and there's just a ridiculous amount of love and care poured into each and every aspect of this game that you kinda hope it blows up in popularity overnight. The devs definitely deserve it. First of all, look at the graphics of this thing. Everything is so well made, so refined, so much so that to me, it set a new standard for what I expect from this kind of game moving forward. Circuit Superstars is laser focused on being a racing game and nothing else. And this laser focus brings about a number of things we still don't have in many AAA racing games. Fuel consumption and tire wear? Check. Performance altering damage? Check. Weight transfer and body roll? Check. Cars that handle dramatically different from one another? Check. Animated pit crew? Check. Long races that take pit strategies into account? Check. Crossplay? Check. No, seriously, this game has it all. It's all built around being a racing game that's fun to play. There are a lot of different car categories and each one of them feels so different to drive. You really need to learn how to master each one of them. The AI here is well done too. Even at lower difficulties, there's a certain level of challenge that only goes up the higher you go. Now, make no mistake, this is an arcade racer, but I'd say this one has a heavier focus on the simulation aspect than most other arcade racing games you played before. And because of that, racing lines matter more here than most other arcade racers. The lines you take and how smoothly you take them will be the difference between fighting for first place or being lapped. And believe me when I say I've been lapped plenty of times online already. Have I told you this game has online multiplayer and that most races are long enough for pit strategies to make a huge difference in the outcome? And I haven't had any trouble finding people to play with online, which makes me so happy. Hope it keeps going for years. There's a weekly time trial mode and also a free Top Gear DLC where you compete against the Ghost of Super GT, Jimmy Broadbent, and a bunch of other YouTube people. You can customize the colors and to some extent the liveries of both your cars as well as your driver's helmet and suit. And the soundtrack is so good. Props to Pascal Michael, who composed all of the songs in this game. What an awesome job you did. You can listen to the whole thing on Spotify and, if I'm not mistaken, Apple Music too. But anyways, I've gone on long enough on this one. In all seriousness, go play Circuit Superstars. It's a very well-made game that's hard to put down once you start playing it. Circuit Superstars is available on PC and Xbox for now, but it's coming to PlayStation and Nintendo Switch pretty soon. On the first video I did, I put a bonus recommendation at the end that's not necessarily a racing game, but one that has racing elements to it. I'm officially making it a tradition moving forward, so here's the bonus game for this one. I bought Neon Drive back in 2017, I believe, and I'm not gonna lie, that was a purchase entirely driven by the visuals. But this game is so much more than just visuals. Now, this is not a racing game, this is a rhythm game. The only thing you do is switch lanes to avoid obstacles, and it just so happens that the obstacles are always in sync with the music. So whenever you move your car, you're basically following the beat. At first glance, you start playing and you think that's all there is to it. It isn't until you start making some progress, unlocking more stages, that you realize how creative the devs have been with this game. There are just so many cool ideas that happen as you play through the stages, like for example, when the game switches to a top-down view, or when it has you flying, or even defying gravity. And there might be even more I wasn't even able to check for myself, because even after all these years, I'm still stuck in some of the later stages, unable to progress. This game is difficult. It takes a lot of trial and error before you make it through the end of a stage. And since more stages unlock only after a certain progression percentage is met, you need to clear stages you're stuck into first before getting to play newer ones. And since this is a rhythm game, the soundtrack is more important than the driving mechanics, and thankfully, Neon Drive nails it in this department. If you like cars, neon-filled gorgeous visuals, and good music, go give Neon Drive a try. Neon Drive is available on PC, PlayStation 4, and Nintendo Switch. That's all I have for this video. If you found a game you enjoyed, or if this video gave you an idea of what game to play, leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and I'll talk to you on the next one.